better than Sonali Bendre to take us through her journey. A journey that is definitely with a lot of pain, but triumph in the end of it. Sonali, just a few things that we'd like to know from the people in Hyderabad. Yes, it's a difficult journey, but what made you say that I want to share this journey?
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for coming today. And well, it's in the same way as I asked myself, why was it that I was coming here today? But when I put it out, I was just sharing with the world what was happening to me because I did not want gossip around it. I did not want it to be misconstrued. I did not want my son to hear it in a wrong way. But what started as just sharing my story kind of became a dialogue. It became a dialogue in the sense the response I got when I shared my story was so amazing. And it just made me realize that there were people from all stratas of the society writing in, from every, from north, south, east, west, from all over the country, all over the world, in fact, writing in and sharing their stories. It was like an outpouring which shocked me. And I just realized that, oh my God, there's so much of it out there. And first of all, it made me feel that I was not alone. And I just, the next time, it was more like saying thank you for sharing so many stories with me, because it made me realize that I was not alone. There was nothing so very special about me. It's pretty regular. It happens to a lot of people. It's just not spoken about. So it, the next post was just to thank people, to thank you, thanking them for sharing their story with me. And then the dialogue just kind of organically continued.
Okay. Sonali, one thing that you did very differently was you created this thing with the today's world where you created these hashtags, which was one day at a time, bring on the sunshine. Yeah. Was it more to do with affirmations that you believed with, or was it more to tell yourself or tell the people, and why that hashtag, and what does those hashtag mean to you?
Well, you know, now when I look at it, because frankly, I walked into cancer, so to say, completely oblivious to something that really happens in the world, something that a lot of people go through, and quite frankly, touch wood, my life has been so healthy. I eat healthy, I barely have any vices, so it's not something that I expected. I didn't expect a disease. So it was such a shock, and it came out of so, like, it just blindsided me completely. That till now, now when I look back, I understand that these are affirmations, as you say.
Correct.
But at that point of time, I had never really used those, you know, and I didn't really know that this is what happens and this is how it is and everything. But it was more like one day at a time was something that Goldie kept telling me, because, you know, we were so overwhelmed and we didn't know what was happening and we were kind of grappling with the whole situation. And it was like, you know, what are we going to do? And he said, you know what, Sonali, let's just deal with today. Yeah. Let's just deal with today and we'll figure out tomorrow. Let's just deal today. And so it was like one day at a time, one day at a time. He would keep telling me that. And so it became one day at a time. And I love monochromes and grays and whites and blacks. And, you know, it was all this grayness around me, which I normally love. And I said, you know what? It's now time to switch on the sunshine. I want brightness. I want life around me. And that's where it came, switch on the sunshine. And I said, you know what? What another better way to kind of say it than in today's world? Because that's how, you know, my son now talks. You know how the kids talk, anything. Hashtag so-and-so,
yes.
LOL, and stuff like that. So I just said that, you know, this is like switch on the sunshine, switch on the sunshine. I said, you know, if Ranveer was here, he would say hashtag switch on the sun. And that's where it came from. And I said, why not? Let me just use it. And let me just use it really every day. So it was like a mantra to me. And
correct.
I kept saying that. Now what I realize is affirmation. And it, you know, kind
works.
Of worked for me.
Yeah.
At that point, it was just an instinct. And instinctively is what I was doing it. But I'm glad I did it.
Perfect. One more question I have. I'm a mother of an 8-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
You're a mother of a 13-year-old.
Yeah.
Was it difficult for you to decide whether to share this with him or not to share him, protect him? And I believe you went one step further and you actually even took him for those therapy sessions.
Yes.
Where as mothers, our instinct is to protect and not share so much of detail.
Yeah.
Why did you do that and do you really think that's
helpful?
Again,
it was an instinct to have him with me. And at that point of time, I mean, I know my parents, my mother-in-law, I live with my mother-in-law and my sister-in-law, we live in a joint family. So I knew there was more than enough support and more than enough love for him. And, you know, he would be pampered and he would be very well taken care of. There was no doubt in my mind about that. But I needed to see his body language because, you know, children can internalize things. And it's great if they understand it and they move on from it. But if there's anything that he's not holding on, then Goldie and me wanted him to be in front of us. Mm-hmm. And somewhere, he's part of the family. And I just felt that these are the things that as a family, we need to deal with it. And well, at that point of time, somewhere for me, it was what, even if I don't, if this was going to be the last, then I really needed him with me. It was literally like, you know, in this last month or 2 months, whatever it is that I have, what is it that I want to teach him? Then there were certain lessons that I needed to share with him and I needed him with me for that. Right. So, yeah.
Okay. It's a bit. One question before I open it up here. Your first advertisement was Parachute Hair Oil.
Yeah.
You have been known for those beautiful dresses. And trust me, this looks even better. So now with this new thing, you took this industry, which is so obsessed with beauty, so obsessed with that perfect thing, to this new thing. Is it difficult? Mm-hmm. You even did that amazing photo shoot with Vogue India recently, where you've shown off your scar. Some pointers for people like that, so we are not obsessed with ourselves.
It's hard.
It's hard.
It is, yeah. And I think it is for everybody because, you know, we are brought up, I mean, my mother would kind of whack me if I stood in front of a mirror for too long. That's the way she brought us up. We have three daughters. And that's her way of not really letting it get to the head, so to say, as they say. But the fact remains that how much ever we might say, and we are taught with it, that inner beauty is important, and which is true, it is. That's what shines through eventually. But the fact remains that it takes a while to figure the inner beauty out. And what you see first is the outer beauty, and that's what it is. Plus, like you said, that's my profession. That's what has given me my bread, butter, jam, you know, and a few more perks on top of that has been this. This has been the livelihood. And so it was scary. But also the point was that either I could be scared and sit at home and not face the world, or it was like when you get scared, just step out and do exactly what you're scared of. Because the moment I did that, it was out there. What else is there to be scared of? Okay, I don't want to show my head, but it's out there. So, you know, it was every time, it was more like everything that scared me, I kind of put it out there. So you're scared of what? What is it that you fear? I mean, forget other than the fact that, you know, you want to live and you don't want to die. You fear the fact that what will people say? How will it look? So here it is. Say whatever it is that you have to say.
So
and you just kind of cross that. There's so much to deal with. I didn't want to add one more thing to deal with. That, you know, how am I looking? What is happening? And quite frankly, we underestimate, in all the teachings of inner beauty, we underestimate the I'm sorry to say it, but we underestimate the magic of makeup. A bit of lipstick and kajal goes a great way in giving you self-confidence.
Definitely. Before I open the session, one point for your sister. Like we said, this whole thing is about women power and that. She's been your rock.
Yeah.
She's been through this whole thing. She's here today. Yeah. Thank you so much for coming in today. What is it that you say? So women support women and that is women power, right?
So in my journey, there have been both my sisters, because my eldest sister is here with me. My younger one has twins and so is not. But she's been a part of this journey. And my sisters-in-law, they have been like rocks for me also, because they have held the fort back here and they have traveled up and down. She's been the constant, but they have all been there completely for me. And my biggest pillar of strength has been my husband.
Absolutely.
So this has been my support system, my friends, my sisters, and which includes my sisters-in-law, all of them. But what you said is a very, very important thing, that, you know, there are certain things that women understand.
Absolutely.
And there are a lot of times that you realize that it's women who... There are a lot of times who don't want to be the ones who are supporting and helping. But if we could just do that, because there are certain things that only women can understand, you know, that how much ever sympathetic and empathy a man might have, there's certain things that can be shared with women. And so if women can come together and be like you know, be a support system for each other, I think we can do wonders.
Wonders to that whole thing. One thing that you look forward in 2019?
I hope I can hear the word remission. And I just hope for that.
Definitely. We hope for that too.